Welcome to another episode of Context is King. I'm Eric, joined as always by Ash. How you doing?
Pretty good.
So Vice, by the time this publishes, Vice Media may very well have a new CEO. What are we thinking?
I'm not really surprised. I think Shane Smith really deserves an award and should be in the Hall of Fame of like content for making content sexy. Mm-hmm. You know, I mean, almost Shane single-handedly made private equity guys and big media companies come out and pay such a premium to ride the Vice train.
Do you think, let me just ask right off the bat, do you think that when they started their punk zine way back in the day, that they had the savvy? Like,
no,
is it
not
something
at all.
They
no,
accrued?
No.
Or?
No, no. I mean, look, first of all, to go back, I didn't finish the answer
because I
think in this era, he had to go, unfortunately. But we can come to that. Yeah. So just to jump to your question. No, I don't think they had the savvy, and I don't think they would admit that they had their savvy. I've met Shane only a couple times in person, but we've emailed and chatted quite a bit, like dozens of times over the years. If you read also their stuff, they admit that they weren't necessarily like business savvy, but I think Shane is the consummate sales guy. Shane, by his own admission, forget selling ice to an Eskimo, he could sell shit to the poop master of all time. Like, that's what he does, you know? And he gets up there and he'll say stuff that may not even be true, but people just are like, okay, it's like, and in a boom market, when they see revenues growing and other people lining up to sign checks and get on the cap table, other people then kind of want to get ahead of the line. But I think a lot of it was kind of parlaying that anti-establishment shtick to billions of dollars in valuations despite the fact that they were bringing all these corporations on board.
Right.
So you knew that eventually something was going to give. Now, a lot of people felt that, okay, as you bring on investors, despite thinking that you may be in charge of the board and whatnot, you ultimately serve that master and not anybody else. That was a plausible outcome. Other people felt, okay, if they actually go do an IPO, he won't want to be the CEO of an IPO, publicly traded company. Other people thought that eventually just the lifestyle might get to him and he may be burnt out. But look, I think the Me Too and Time's Up movement is serious. You know, I've said that this is like the Emancipation Proclamation. I think this is kind of like the civil rights movements. This is a long overdue correction and day of reckoning. And as much as Shane was early on saying, look, I'm no Harvey Weinstein or whomever, I've been very vocal and public about our roots and origins. If you are privately held with no corporate or institutional investors on your cap table, you could have kind of gone outside of the shadow and maybe survived. But in this era, I just felt like, and then combined with the fact that they missed revenue targets by $100 million, despite having their best year ever, despite the fact that it's a two-way street, context is king, is sure, they've grown their value to $5.7 billion, which is awesome, but that means there's less and less exit options for them. So I think when you kind of bring all the factors together, Shane was a figurehead that the Me Too movement was like, yo, this can't stay. And I feel like the bigger thing is, he probably, when this all started, had people on his board that were like, I'm your biggest fan, Shane. Don't have to worry. Let's just ride it out. Whenever somebody says, I'm your biggest fan, they've probably already slept in your bed, so to speak. Mm. You know. So I think that was just something that was going to happen. And if you think about it, the New York Times expose came out around Christmas, like Christmas Eve.
Yeah.
And I feel like for the past 2-3 months, he's probably been behind the scenes trying to... this is all guess, right? I mean,
right.
This is just... You know, I think he probably has been trying to salvage his spot as CEO. If I were him, I would have done it differently.
Well, so who... Let's talk about the person that is most rumored to be taking over that spot.
Well, I don't think it's a rumor. I think it's A&E CEO Nancy Dubuc, who is basically, you know, A&E gave them the channel that became Viceland.
Right.
The ratings aren't doing too well. Of all the corporates, I don't think... The only person that I thought might be made sense to come in as interim would be Tom Freston.
But
he's like 70-ish, and he probably doesn't want to be day-to-day, and he's like, why the hell would I walk into that situation?
And imagine him advice.
Yeah, imagine him advice, but the thing is, he deserves a lot of credit for getting Vice to what it is. You know, he kind of knew media like the back of his hand. But I don't think it would have looked well if you replaced Shane Smith with an old white dude either, to be honest. I mean, that just...
So instead, Nancy Dubuc, is it significant? You know, you mentioned Me Too and Time's Up. In this era, is it significant that Vice Media would appoint a woman as CEO of what was formerly known as pretty much a boys' club?
Does Snoop Dogg like weed? Yes. I mean, it's a no-brainer. Now, to be fair, those who come out and say she only got the job because she's a female, that's stupid because she has a Midas touch, or is seen. Nobody has actually a Midas touch. It's a perception. The perception, and based on her track record, is she has like the Midas touch of programming in terms of like show picking. She's the one that greenlit Dynasty Duck. She's been
Duck
on
Dynasty.
Like Duck Dynasty. Sorry, yeah. She's the one who like before any of this happened, Vanity Fair picked as like top 100 movers and shakers of the new establishment. You know, she has a tremendously... It's funny because last night I looked up her LinkedIn profile, which is totally underestimates what she's done. It only shows A&E CEO. Mm-hmm. But when you actually go and research what she's done, she has a prolific career. So I think it makes a lot of sense. I think it was more because of the Viceland needs to remedy that, so to speak. And she knows that intimately well. And A&E wants to protect its investment. And I think if you're Disney, Fox, or any of the other companies... You don't necessarily want to parachute your own guy because it's such a thorny situation. So this presents itself as an envious, elegant solution. But again, if I was Shane, I would have played it very differently.
How would you have done it?
Well, I mean, if you want to go total Godfather mode, if I like to say if you're not part of the solution, you are the problem. Mm-hmm. I think if I'm Shane, once I start hearing in cue... And Shane, by the way, was always very... I mean, you could criticize Shane for a lot. Shane, in my career, gave me some very good advice. And if there was any way that I would have... If you would have cared to listen to my two cents, I would have, you know, offered it, despite the fact that, you know, Vice right now is a bit of a thorny brand. But if I'm Vice, I would... When I hear that this New York Times expose is coming out, I would basically go out there and start to look for my replacement. And I would basically say, I got to...
Handpick your own.
Not necessarily handpick my own, but if you really even want to salvage your own neck and come back, I mean, you could go gangster and even get that person to kind of agree to eventually have a timeline, which is what Travis at Uber wanted to do. He wanted to go get somebody and then kind of after a few years, leave the door open for him to come back. I think maybe that's the story with Nancy, but by clinging on to the CEO role more and more, you become kind of more and more toxic. Not talking Shane, in general. Mm-hmm. Like if people come on board and for whatever reason, let's say I bring on investors and it, you know, if they say, Ash, we need to bring fresh blood, you could say no once or twice. But if you really, really start to cling on, then they just kind of get more and more aggressive, and then it becomes less about you and your role. It's just about, you know, I'm saying A, you're saying B, I'm going to really fight for A. So here, I think if Shane would have gone ahead of that and bowed out in fall and then brought somebody on, then he would have probably had a better chance to make a return. I don't even think he really cares to make a return if he leaves. He probably pocketed hundreds of millions of dollars of the $900 million that they've raised. Good for him. You know, it's his right. He, on paper, is worth billions of dollars. I think he'll probably want to ride into the sunset, just take a break from this, and then come back doing something different. And he'll always still be like the... He'll probably remain, I'm guessing, chairman of Vice. And even if he's not the chairman, just through ownership, you know, he'll remain like the head honcho there, so to speak. But I did always think that this was it was kind of inevitable.
You know, there's something else I want to bring into the discussion. We have about a minute. But National Geographic, Nat Geo yesterday released a statement that...
Well, again, that's a perfect thing. So Nat Geo comes out and says, we were going to go look at like racism in media or racism amongst cultures. And we said, hey, let's slow the train. Let's go take a look at ourselves. That's getting ahead of it. Mm-hmm. That's knowing that, hey, if you put this out there, people are going to be like, hey, Nat Geo, meet this mirror. You guys are freaking phonies. You always describe black people as they won't admit it, this. You described Africans as savages. You described Aboriginal Australians as like, you know, idiots and all that. How dare you come and pinpoint to others? That's getting ahead of yourself. Now, I'm not saying that gives them like, hey, scot-free, you don't have to answer for how you've treated certain people in the past, but that's an example of getting ahead of yourself. And it just goes to show times have changed.
Yeah, and context is king. Thank you very much. We will have much more for you. Stay tuned and we'll talk to you soon.